إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear brothers, today inshallah we'll continue our session or درس or our discussion in Tajweed, which we had last week about the introduction of Tajweed and مبادئ العلوم العشرة in Tajweed. We talk about the مبادئ فن التجويد. We talk about the تعريف of تجويد, which is the definition of تجويد. We said التجويد لغة التحسين. We said التجويد لغة التحسين. And we say الصلاح هو إخراج كل حرف من مخرجه مع إعطائه حقه ومستحقه. And we had this book for this تجويد. It's called البرهان في تجويد القرآن للشيخ محمد صادق أو محمد الصادق قمحاوي. One of the summarized book in تجويد is very good for the beginners because it's very simple and very summary of knowledge of تجويد. And also we talk about the role of تجويد حكم. What this scholar said, he said the تجويد Imam الشاطبي, he said the condition or the rule is compulsory for all of us to understand or to study or to read the Tajweed. But most of the scholars said the compulsory is to recite on Tajweed, to recite on Tajweed, not to learn about the Tajweed, but to recite is compulsory. But even as we mentioned, Sheikh Muhammad bin Saleh Al-Uthaymeen, he said even though to recite in Tajweed is not compulsory, Sheikh Muhammad bin Saleh Al-Uthaymeen said to recite in Tajweed also is not compulsory, it's Sunnah, but is compulsory in Surah Al-Fatiha to recite the letters very well. The letters, the Tashkil is very compulsory, because if someone doesn't recite the Al-Fatiha, the letters and the Tashkil correctly, that means his Fatiha is not correct. It means his Salah is not correct. And even this, it comes as to something that we cannot follow. Imam doesn't recite Al-Fatiha correctly. If you hear Imam, he doesn't recite Al-Fatiha correctly, don't follow him. Don't follow Imam, doesn't recite Al-Fatiha correctly, because Al-Fatiha is compulsory in our prayer. And we mentioned that inshallah today we'll be continuing about Maratib Al-Qira'ah. Maratib Al-Qira'ah, what they call the types of recitation, or the level of recitation, or the categories of the recitation. In Al-Qira'ah we have like different types of recitation, even though that in here, in this book, he mentioned like some of it might you read in other books different order or different, sometimes different words. Like I said, أولا الترتيل. See, مراتب القراءة أربعة. The category or the types of قراءة, see, أربعة. Four of it. See, أولا الترتيل. وهو القراءة بتؤادة واطمئنان وإخراج كل حرف من مخرجه ما يعطيه حقه أو حقه ومستحقه مع تدبر المعاني. They said the first type or the first the category in the إقراءة الترتيل. الترتيل it goes the same from رتل الشيء أي أتى متتابعا. And it goes in Arabic language, they said الترتيل it means something came after each other. It's not like something, it's not like very fast, it's not very slow, but it came in order, it came after each other. Even they said from ratalat or annaqa or something like this, that it walks very slowly and it is walk like after each other. He said, وهو القراءة بتؤدة. And now he make the explanation about the الترتيل. He said, هو القراءة بتؤدة واطمئنان وإخراج كل حرف مخرجي معطائي حق هو مستحق. And this is the main things of the recitation. Because even in Quran, he came with this name. You see, ورتل القرآن ترتيلا. ورتل القرآن ترتيلا. It means you recite in a way very calm, not very slow, but in a way that if someone like hearing you or listen to your citation, he will understand what you said and he will listen whatever things you said. And even in hadith, Aisha radiallahu anha, Umm al-Mu'mineen Aisha, Allah anha, she said, they ask her about the recitation of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She said, كانت قراءته فصلا فصلا. It means is separately. فصلا. He said ayah and he stopped. Even in hadith, another hadith, Anas bin Malik, he mentioned that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he said ayah by ayah. He finished ayah, then ayah, then ayah, then ayah. Like this. And even in another hadith, I read it in the book of Sheikh Muhammad al-Harari, he mentioned about like one day Anas bin Malik, he was sitting and he had when he recites in a way that is not aligned with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he asks him, he say, ma hakadha or ma hakadha kunna nasma Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam or something like this, and he start teaching him how the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam he recites. Now, and even there is in other hadith also, if I didn't forget one of the Sahaba with Anas bin Malik or Abdullah bin Abbas, one of the Sahaba or Tabi'in, he was reciting Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, but he was a bit fast. And he said, no, it's not like this, it's Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, something like this. And as you mentioned, the scholar said, most of them, this tajweed is not that, as you said, they said it's compulsory, but as Sheikh Muhammad Mathamin mentioned that the compulsory part, it is to recite Al-Fatiha correctly. And as we mentioned last week, they said Al-Fatiha has 8 or 9 shadda. If you miss one shadda, also your Fatiha is not correct. All the shaddat in Fatiha is very compulsory. All the letter is compulsory and tashkil is compulsory, especially on the salah. Especially on the salah. And this at tartil, mostly, this is the normal recitation and the best way of recitation. As we mentioned, because it came with the hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. And this one, this type of recitation, people use it normally everywhere. You can use it in salah, in halaqa of tahfidh, in normal recitation, if someone like want to recite, in everywhere this type of recitation. And they said the second one, they say at-tahqiq. And sometime in other book you may see this one at tahqiq, they mention it, they call it as at tajweed. And even now, if you go to the YouTube and you write Sheikh Muhammad Sadiq, Muhammad Sadiq Al Minshawi, qira'a mujawwada, it comes with different citation, like while he writes qira'a murattala. When you write qira'a murattala, it comes like normal, but if you write qira'a mujawwada, a bit slow. Even there is a mushaf al-mujawwad, a mushaf al-murattal, if you go and type or search about it. It the same things with these things. As we mentioned, sometimes it will have different name. In this book, they say at-tahqiq. The same in other book, they call it at-tajweed. He said, وَهُوَ مِثِلْ التَّرْتِيلِ إِلَّا أَنَّهُ أَكْثَرَ منه اطمئنانا وهو المأخوذ به في مقام التعليم. التحقيق أو التجويد is similar to ترتيل but is more slow. Slower than the تجويد. الصف الله slower than the ترتيل. It's very slow. And it goes with sometimes with each letter or each word. Especially we use these things normally in tahfiz or in any like learning places of Quran. If you go for, you want to learn, you want to, people like teach, normally teach with this type of qira'ah. Because the teachers, they want to, the student to hear what they are saying or what they are reciting. They go each letter, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, like this. Each letter, they try. And even as you mentioned, even nowadays, if you go to YouTube and search qira'ah mujawwada, so it comes to you very slow, very slow. Maybe like for one page, maybe 20 minutes or something, yeah. 20 minutes sometime or 10 minutes for one page. While the normal citation maybe like five pages in 10 minutes or something like this. Mujawwada is very slow. The other one, they say al-hadr. The third type, they say al-hadr. The third one, al-hadr. وهو الإسراع في القراءة مع مراعاة الأحكام. Al-hadr, الإسراع في القراءة مع مراعاة الأحكام. They said a bit, you go fast. The mean fast, not to go fast like some people. No. Like this one. Not like you go fast, yes, you're sad on your own, no. You go fast, in tajweed, the ahkam, they have a minimum and maximum. There is minimum ahkam, there is maximum ahkam. When you recite fast, this type of citation, al-hadr, you will take with the minimum ahkam, like minimum. Of mad. Al-wajib, al-mufassil, you take the minimum one. Of mad, everything, take the minimum ahkam. The minimum ahkam. That's why he said, وهو الإسراع في القراءة مع مراعاة الأحكام. Al-ahkam should be there. Not like you recite in our own, no. Even that, if you recite in al-hadr, we should follow the ahkam of tajweed. And normally this type of recitation, you listen to it in Ramadan, mostly. Ramadan, mostly. Most of the shuyukh, if recite in Taraweeh, they recite with Al-Hadr, mostly. Not all, but mostly they recite in Al-Hadr. Even if you listen to the shuyukh of Haram, whether Mecca or Medina, in Taraweeh is different. When they recite in Taraweeh, it's different from their normal recitation. Like if you listen to the Sheikh Mahir Al-Ma'igli or Balila nowadays, or even Sheikh Isidis or Shireem, in Taraweeh, it's different from you listen to them like in normal like prayer, Isha or Fajr or anything. It's different. In Taraweeh, a bit, they recite with Hadr. Because subhanAllah, even the scholars say, for us, like as a beginners, not good to listen to the Taraweeh qira'ah. If you want to learn, because we, like as a beginners, want to learn. You want to learn about the tajweed, about the ahkam, very correct. But if you listen to the Taraweeh qira'at or qira'ah, you won't like hear the things very well. That's why I try to follow like normal qira'at, normal qira'at. And even subhanAllah, there is, as we mentioned last week, there is some of shuyukh, the other shuyukh, they recommended them for beginners like us, like Sheikh Muhammad Sadiq Al-Minshawi, very good. Also, Al-Hudayfi, mashallah, is very good for us to listen. Because when you listen to him, even there is Sheikh Ibrahim Al-Akhdar. Yeah, he's not. For nowadays, people they won't like feel like interesting, or because they don't have that melody, the weave with the sound or things, but their recitation is very, very powerful. And for us, it's very good if you listen to them. Like you'll hear the ahkam, the letters, how it is like pronounced. You will hear the other ahkam, idhar, idgham, ikhfa, with noon sakina, with meem sakina. It's very clear. It's very clear. And the last one, they said التدوير. التدوير, they said, هو مرتبة متوسطة بين الترتيل والحدر. التدوير, there is other level of قراءة, they said التدوير. التدوير, they said something or the level between ترتيل and حدر. It's not a bit slow, also it's not that fast. Even sometimes, like many shiukh, they recite in this one, التدوير. Like you see him, like sometimes, like when he recite, he a bit like recite slow in certain place, and other place you go a bit like fast. It means it's not fast, it's not slow. Like between these two, ترتيل and الحدر. And he said, and Sheikh Muhammad Sadiq Qamhawi, he recommended one of the qira'a. He said, وَأَفْضَلْ هَذِهِ الْمَرَاتِبِ التَّرْتِيلِ لِنُزُولِ الْقُرْآنِ بِهِ كما قال تعالى وَرَتَّلْنَاهُ تَرْتِيلًا. And he said, and the best one among all this one, التَّرْتِيلِ, because of the دليل came with this one. الترتيل, الله سبحانه وتعالى سي ورتل القرآن ترتيلا, وهذا آية ورتلناه ترتيلا. And the other one, and the other topic, he start talking about الاستعاذة. الاستعاذة and بسملة. استعاذة and بسملة, and even the condition and rule of the استعاذة and بسملة. سي حكمها هي مستحبة وقيل واجبة. مستحبة وقيلة واجبة عند القراءة أو عند بدء القراءة, because the other آية الله سبحانه وتعالى said, وإذا قرأت القرآن فاستعذ بالله من شيطان الرجيم. Because some scholars said this is compulsory. If someone want to start the قراءة, it's compulsory for him to say أعوذ بالله من شيطان الرجيم, because in آية الله سبحانه وتعالى سيد وإذا قرأت القرآن استعذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Even though some said is not compulsory, as he said هي مستحبة وقيل واجبة. Even him, he said it is مستحبة. Even Sheikh Muhammad صدق محاوي said it is مستحبة. سي وقيل واجبة عند البدء بالقراءة, وصيغتها المختارة أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. This is the common صيغة. There is other صيغة. Sometimes you will hear أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. Like different صيغات, but this one is the common one. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. And he said ولها أربع حالات. ولها أربع حالات, حالتان يجهر بها فيهما, وحالتان يسر بها فيهما, فيجهر بها في المحافل والتعليم, ويسر بها في الصلاة والانفراد. And he mentioned the way that we recite, or the condition of the condition of أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. In the recitation, he said he has four conditions. See, two of it is loud. We recite it loud. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Two of the condition that is loud place. Said في المحافل والتعليم. في المحافل والتعليم, in place like if want to, if there is any sometime, even nowadays, if you have like anything like Some, like not all people like doing this, but it's common nowadays. If there is any ceremony or things or any like gathering, people just start with Quran, even though Muslim Sheikh says it's not good. Even I read for Sheikh Muhammad Mathemin says it's not good. Because Quran is not meant to be like for opening or something. Even something is good, we start with Quran. But as we mentioned, in Islam is not about the good, about the Sunnah. Yeah, if anyone say good, will reach to some age that Islam will disappear. We'll replace it with our good things. Good. Even it is happening nowadays, it's common. But I read Sheikh Muhammad Al-Athimi said it's not Sunnah, it's not good. Not like for opening, sometimes even in if people they have this nikah or something, nikah, this engagement ceremony, something, oh, Fatiha. Before that, even see, now they use it in many places, in everywhere, especially like part in any ceremony. Yeah, you start with the Quran. But Sheikh Muhammad Taymin, I read, says not that good, because it's not the, because the Prophet Muhammad and the Sahaba, they were there and they have all these type of things and they didn't do it. Why we do it as nowadays? It said أربع حالات يمنشن في المحافل وفي التعليم. المحافل as you mentioned in ceremonies and so on, but as you mentioned many شيوخ say it's not good, that it was not in the Sunnah. And I said وفي التعليم. التعليم in any place that like teaching place. Yeah, when you start reciting, start with أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. And he said, وحالتان يسر بهما. And there's two other conditions. It is secret or hide. Too loud and too hide or secret. He said, ولها يسر بهما في الصلاة والانفراد. I say, in a prayer, it is hiding. It's not like something like you start it like loud. And even he said al-infrad in when you recite alone, also it is secret, it hide. I don't know why, but he mentioned that for salah al-infrad. And also he mentioned about the basmala, bismillah ar-rahman ar-rahim, because we have two, a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, bismillah ar-rahman الرحيم. And البسملة we will have only small talk about the البسملة, because we'll have it again in تفسير إن شاء الله tomorrow. We'll have it again, we'll talk about the البسملة in detail tomorrow إن شاء الله in تفسير. But here only we have like small. Yeah, even البسملة he said the same condition, too high and too loud, too high and too loud. But about the al-basmala, as we know, they had like talk about it. There is a bit like different opinion in madahib and even in iskala about the al-basmala. Like while it is like compulsory or not compulsory, and most important things like which it is compulsory in Al-Fatiha or not compulsory, or it is part of Al-Fatiha or not. Yeah, this one even like madhahib they have different. Like this why when you came to Malaysia here, you see all the imams, they recite with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Because في madhahib Imam Shafi'i, in Shafi'iyya in general, Basmala is part of Al-Fatiha. Part of Al-Fatiha. But the other madhahib, Basmala is not part of Al-Fatiha, which is Jumhur, and which is inshallah is the correct one. It's not part of Al-Fatiha. But most of this, all of them, they said Basmala, it is ayah in Quran. It is ayah. Ayah in Quran to separate the surah. Between surah and another surah, there is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim to separate the surah. And it is part of Surah An-Naml. No doubt, innahu min Sulaiman, wa innahu Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Even as we mentioned that Sulaiman alayhi salam, in the first one, he recite Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. As Iskana said, in the first one, he recited Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It is, as we mentioned, most of the scholars said is not part of Al-Fatiha. Because of what? But it is some of them, they said, is compulsory to recite it. Some say it's not compulsory to recite it. But it's good to recite it. Even like, but it's not loud. See, now we have like four topics now. Okay, now we go now for those that they said is not compulsory, but they say is okay. No, for those they said is not part of Al-Fatiha, but some said is compulsory to recite it loud. Some said is not compulsory to recite it like loud. But even that, whether you recite it loud or not loud, as you mentioned, is very good for us like to know. Some, for them, it is compulsory. It means, if you hear someone say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, even loud, don't come, why? It's okay. Not like something that you came and argue with someone with him. Because the, like, even though that is not the stronger hadith, or this, not the stronger opinion, but there is opinion, and there is hadith, even though it's not that strong, but there is hadith, there is opinion. Don't need to go, but sometimes, subhanAllah, why this one, why? If it's, all is okay, inshallah. But it's good for us to know that it's not part of Fatiha. Because if you consider Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, part of Fatiha, it means you have to treat Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim similar to Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, loud and compulsory. Because imagine someone came and recited Al-Fatiha, and said with Rahman Rahim Malik Yawmiddin. No way. Isn't it? If someone came and you following someone and you start with Rahman Rahim Malik Yawmiddin, it's wrong. I say that the talk about Bismillah al-Basmala is a bit quite long, inshallah. Tomorrow we have it in detail, inshallah, in session of tafsir. But now in general, that for us, like living in Malaysia, it's good to know that Shafi'iyah, they have it. Imam Shafi'i said, yeah, it's part of Al-Fatiha. And even if you read book of Sheikh Muhammad Al-Harari, his introduction, also he talk about it, Sheikh Muhammad Al-Harari, that, yeah, in Shafi'iyah, it is, because even Sheikh Muhammad Al-Harari is Shafi'i, mashallah. Now Sheikh Muhammad Hari is Shafi'i, he talk about it. That Shafi'iyah, the mention, it is part of Al-Fatiha. And even they said, okay, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنْ الْمَثَانِي, that is seven ayat. And people, they consider, for those that they consider Al-Fatiha, they said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, one, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Rahman ar-Rahim, Malikum al-Din, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. 7. But for those don't consider بسم الله is part of Al-Fatiha, we start with الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. Here is آية. See, أنعمت عليهم is آية. Then, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. This was, subhanAllah, even now, if you go and read, for example, مصحف طباعة, مصحف طباعة الملك فهد, this one is not, I think it's one of the, No, it's not from King Fahad, like publisher of Quran in Medina. Before it was the change of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. See, before it was, it's the first ayah started with Alhamdulillah Alameen, but the new طبعات they started with Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Similar to this one. Similar to this one. See, first ayah, Bismillah Rahman Rahim. But if you see the old Quran, King Fahad, طبعات الملك Fahad, they started with Alhamdulillah Rabb Alameen. But now it's started with Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Even though if you read Sheikh Muhammad Ibn Uthaymeen and Ibn Baz, they said Bismillah Rahman Rahim is not part of Al-Fatiha, and this the Jumhur, like what they said, is not part of Al-Fatiha, even though, as mentioned, Shafi'i, they said, is part of Al-Fatiha, and they have the Hadith, inshallah, whatever someone he does, inshallah, there's no problem. And he said, أولها مع البسملة عند أول السورة أربع أوجه. Now he said, الاستعاذة with al-basmala, it have like four types of recitation together in the beginning. See, ولها مع البسمله عند أول السورة, it means الاستعاذة بالبسمله أربع أوجه. He say قطع الجميع. قطع الجميع. You recite it separately all. It means قطع الجميع. الاستعاذة with البسمله with the beginning of the surah. Like you said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Then you said بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Then you said الحمد لله رب العالمين. This قطع الجميع. You said all separately. قطع الجميع أي الاستعاذة عن البسملة والبسملة عن أول السورة. Then he said the other one, the second type, he said قطع الأول ووصل الثاني بالثالث. Sometimes, like you hear Shuyukh, they said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Then they said, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين. They recite الاستعاذة separately, then they join بسملة with the beginning of the other surah. This third one, he said, وصل الأول بالثاني مع الوقف عليه وقطع الثالث. You join the first one and the second one, then you stop and recite with the beginning of the surah. You said أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Then you stop. Then you said الحمد لله رب العالمين. The last one, he said وصل الجميع. And this one mostly you listen it when you hear, especially mashallah Sheikh Abdul Basit Abdul Samad, he had this mashallah always. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب. I had one of the إذا شيخ محمد صديق المنشاوي وعبد الباسط أبو السمد فمعوذ بالله أنت الألف لاميم one prayer ما شاء الله وانت you understand you got to understand maybe you don't imagine وانت ألف لام ميم. ألف لام ميم it means بقرة. فم الحمد وبسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وانت ألف لام ميم بقرة. ما شاء الله. Like how many ayah? 7 or 8. And it's not like الحمد لله. No. Not like just like eating the words. Remember there is our أستاذ. You know when a kid and recite, a bit recite like fast, so you don't eat the words. Alhamdulillah, Rahman, Rahim, some people they do recite like this. Subhanallah. Yes, you hear. I don't know what the. Subhanallah. See, وصل الجميع استعاذة. The fourth one, see, وصل الجميع. أي الاستعاذة بالبسملة ووصل البسملة بأول السورة. يسير ولها بين كل وكل كل سورتين ثلاثة أوجه. This one in the beginning of the surah, and in the middle of the two surah, it has a three condition. This is the four condition that we mentioned now in the beginning. But in the middle, for example, now you're reciting, let us say, قُلْ أَعُوذُ رَبِّ النَّاسِ, and you want to join it with قُلْ أَعُوذُ رَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. Okay, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ and Bismillah, how the condition of it? He said there are three conditions. سَيَقَطَعَ الْجَمِيعِ. It means when you finish الناس, you start أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ separate, and you start Bismillah, then you start قُلْ أَعُوذُ رَبِّ الْفَلَقِ separate. Second one, سَيَقَطَعَ الْأَوَّلِ وصل الثاني بالثالث. Second one, you finish أعوذ بالله, finish قل أعوذ برب الناس, then you start أعوذ بالله, then بسم الله, then قل أعوذ برب الناس. The third one, he said وصل الجميع. وصل الجميع, وزمل, you said the ending of قل أعوذ برب الفلق with أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, then he said قل أعوذ برب الناس. And he said وأما بين الأنفال وبراءة فلك الوقف والسكت والوصل بدون البسملة. This one, it happens in all the Quran, but between أنفال and براءة, we know there is no بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. He said you can't stop. If you want to stop, stop. Or you want to join, you join, but without Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Without Bismillah ar-Rahman, as we know, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is not part of At-Tawbah. Why? Who knows why? Huh? Who knows why? Why Bara'ah doesn't have Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? At-Tawbah. Why doesn't have Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? Aisha. Oh, this one of the opinion. Shadman. Bara'a also. The similar. Similar opinion. Yeah. Same. Yeah, somebody said these things. But subhanAllah, Shaykh Muhammad bin Salih al-Uthaymeen said, all the Quran, it is mercy. Even Bara'a, it came with sword, but all Quran, even Bara'a, there is many ayat, Jannan, so on. All Quran, it mercy. And all Quran, it is Bara'a from shirk. Even قُلْ أَعُوذُ رَبِّ النَّاسِ, even الحمد لله رب العالمين, الحمد لله العالمين, الرحمن الرحيم, مالك يوم الدين, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, it's Bara'a from shirk, from anything. But he said this one, the mentioned opinion according to Ali bin Abi Talib. He said this one, and the scholar they follow up with him. But there is other opinion, which is opinion Uthman bin Affan, Abdullah bin Mas'ud, and even Sheikh Muhammad bin Salih al-Maghamisi said is the better one. There is a riwaya from Uthman bin Affan, he said the time when the Prophet Muhammad, when he revealed to him, when the Quran he revealed to him, he the one he guide the Sahaba, put this one here and put that one here. Yeah, put this ayah here, put this. Of course, Prophet Muhammad, he has people that they write the Quran. He said, put this one here, put that one here, put this surah here, put that surah there. But Uthman said, when the Bara'ah came, because it came after the ending, Anfal and Bara'ah came in the ending of life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Anfal, when the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala either reveal Anfal or Tawbah, he didn't mention to them that to make separate or to put Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim between these two surah, but because they leave it like this. This Sheikh Muhammad bin Salih al-Maghamisi said is the better opinion. Allah Alam, maybe the other one, maybe it might be the better one, but this Sheikh Muhammad Salih al-Maghamisi said this opinion the better one. Yeah, because it has even hadith. Like Abu Hafan, he said there is Prophet Muhammad, he didn't like get them which place. When the Anfal or Tawbah came, He didn't mention to them to put separate or Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim between these two ayah. Because even for those, they said, even the other opinion, even Sheikh Muhammad bin Salih al-Mughamisi, he reconciled about what the other said. Like what they said, they came with the sword. Yeah, Sam. They said, the famous opinion even. It's the famous opinion. Yeah, they said Bara'a doesn't have Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim because it came with the sword with the against Quraysh. But as Sheikh Muhammad al-Mughami said, all the Quran came with these things. And all the Quran came with mercy. All the Quran. Cannot say this surah has no mercy, no. All the Quran is mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all the Quran is came to this twingish, yeah, of, it's correct, huh? Yeah, not use the big word. Let's say, okay, let's use the normal word to differentiate. Muslim and non-Muslim. All Quran came with this. Even as you mentioned, even Fatiha, Allah said, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِيمُ إِهْدِينَ الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمُ صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Even Fatiha, the same things. Yeah. And Allah أعلم. This according to Sheikh Muhammad Salih al-Mughamisi, as I said, it might be even the other one, it's a better one. Allah أعلم. Even if you read other scholar, maybe he will say the other one is more correct or more likely the reason. Allahu alam. Allahu alam which one is more, one is correct or the likely, the close to the reason. But this is what Sheikh Muhammad Salih al-Mughamisi mentioned. And we'll stop here inshallah. And hada wa sallallahu Muhammad wa sahbihi ajma'in. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Bismillah. Ta'ala jaddak. Wa la ilaha ghayra. Bismillah. Thank you.